think one or two more games and I'm done because
All right.
I'm starting to feel the alcohol. I'm like on another planet of existence. I'm like, woo, where am I? No, I don't know if that is the reason I'm scared of snakes, but I wouldn't be surprised if it was, because that really fucked me up when I was a kid. Like, that whole movie was just like, what the fuck is. I'm not playing All Point Bulletin, sorry. No. I've tried playing this game on MAME before. It does not play very good. I'm going to veto that one. Super draw poker. No. I'm having trouble controlling my mouse. I may have had too much to drink.
Actually, you want to know the real odd fear I developed from watching a movie, one that the fire is one my parents kind of got, but this other one is one that they really didn't, and my mother in particular tried to break me of it in the worst possible ways. But for many years, and even to this day, I still kind of get weirded out. I had this is gonna I had I am not joking about this, an irrational fear of plants. Like greenery.
Wow.
And as far as I can tell, it's because when I was very, very young, when I was much, much younger, we went to the movie theater to see the movie Fern Gully, The Last Rainforest. And to this day, I'm not entirely sure what it was about that movie, but I got so horribly frightened that I had to like run out of the theater and wait outside for the movie to finish.
Wow.
And
Fern
so, like,
Gully?
just, yeah. And so, like, from that point on, just like thinking about things like vines creeping up or plants or just like roots going through the ground just like completely scared the shit out of me. And so like my parents would be like, "Help me, can you help us like deal with the weeds?" No. And just any sort of like yard work was a struggle. Like mowing the lawn is one thing, but like dealing with plants directly, like touching them was just real bad for quite a few years there.
Wow. That
And
would.
my mother tried to break me of it a couple of times of being like, "Come here for a second, what is it?" And she like just like grab my hand by force and just like rub a plant all over me, and I'd just be like, "Ah!"
Wow. Fern Gully is weird for that. I would have figured that would have been like Little Shop of Horrors or something.
I've seen Little Shop of Horrors since then. It's just, I.
Seymour!
The weird thing about Little Shop of Horrors is as much as I actually the music is fun and just like watching the film with Rick Moranis is enjoyable. I don't really like the way that ends, but that's just me.
Well, it could use the original ending.
I mean, I've read what the original ending is. It's not. I don't like either of them, honestly.
See, I think the weirdest thing about like Little Shop of Horrors is knowing that the person who voiced Audrey 2 is the same person who voiced Mother Brain on Captain Inn.
100% hear that. Like that's not even a stretch. It's not even like a wow, really. It's just kind of like, no, yeah.
Oh, Captain Inn, that's a show I love that show, but I can understand why everyone hates it. So the game I got was Konami's 80s Gallery. I have no idea what this is, and it's not running, so all
Well,
right.
that makes it easy.
Rant, select a random game. Oishi Puzzle Ha, I can't even. I've had too much alcohol to even try to read that.
It's Sunsoft though, so it's probably safe.
I do love me some Sunsoft. Speaking of Sunsoft, I want to say that Goonies, not Goonies 2, Gremlins 2 on the NES has an under is a very underrated, awesome soundtrack. So.
Oh no, yeah, I don't know what circles you're in, but everyone I know who brings up Gremlins 2 just gushes about the music. It's real solid.
It's really good. It is.
Oh gosh, this seems to be a crossword. Is this a crossword puzzle?
Oh God, I hope not. Is this like just a board game? And
Stato!
Stardo 6. I guess I'll
Take your
go that
pick.
way.
You got that something something.
Japanese. I don't know
Game.
what any of these things are telling me. Oh no! I already don't like this.
It's literally puzzles.
Fuck it, I'm out. I'm out.
All right.
I've had too much alcohol to do puzzles. If it was like that game where we were playing the mouse girl, I could do that. But I, no, Mahjong, fuck that.
Probably not. I'm going to say this is probably not just based on the picture. Sky Kid. This looks promising.
I know this game. I don't know this version of this game, but I know the original game is made by Namco. I do like Namco.
Sky Kid.
Sky Kid, it's like a shooter, except you're going the opposite direction.
Oh my gosh. This makes me think of freaking Tailspin on the NES.
that's valid. Tailspin is sadly the probably most underrated game for the most underrated Disney game on the NES for reasons I will say is completely valid.
I'll say the most underrated Capcom NES game, because yeah. There are some other non-Capcom NES games that are
underrated Capcom NES game. As far as like their series of like Disney afternoon based games, it is the least attentioned one.
Actually, was Disneyland Adventure also Capcom? I can't remember.
You mean the Magic Adventures in the Magic Kingdom?
Yeah. I think that one might actually have it beat. That one's the one that no one ever talks about. Tailspin at least gets some mention.
I think you're right, because at least Tailspin got mentioned. It at least is in that like collection that Capcom released.
Yeah.
The Magic Kingdom game isn't. Fuck this game. I'm done. All right, but yeah, but it, of the ones based on the Disney afternoon cartoons, it's the least.
Yeah, for sure.
Because it gets overshadowed by DuckTales and Rescue Rangers and Darkwing Duck, even though the Darkwing Duck game is literally just Mega Man. Let's be honest.
To a point, like, it has a lot of things in common with Mega Man, but it also has a few extra things that I think really just kind of give it its own thing. Like being able to use your cape to deflect bullets, being able to climb up, hang on the bottom of the ledges and climb up and also jump down.
It does have some differences, but it was the one I felt was the least different of the bunch. Like,
I still really like Darkwing.
Oh, I love it. Don't get me wrong on that. But it's the one that feels like, literally, it feels the least... It feels like Capcom was being a little less creative with that one compared to the other ones.
So this is essentially RC Pro-Am, except in, like, a weird setting.
Or more exactly, it's post-apocalyptic Super Sprint, if you've ever played that game. It's called the Badlands.
Okay, Super Sprint is a lot like RC Pro-Am as well, though Super Sprint came first, but I mean...
Well, it's also made by the same people who made Super Sprint, a.k.a.
Okay, I gotcha. All right. I think I played Super Sprint once, but I've played RC Pro-Am more than a few times.
RC Pro-Am is one of those games I both like and hate at the same time.
I'm sorry, I was mistaken. I wasn't thinking RC Pro-Am, I was thinking of... I was thinking of Super Off-Road.
Oh, dude, that game's awesome.
My favorite thing that will forever be that instead of this, you have a steering wheel, but instead of like turning to turn, you just kind of just spin it around like a madman. Just like a real steering wheel.
RC Pro-Am is one of those games I both like and hate at the same time, but I think a lot of Rare's early games can be described as that, so.
Yeah, RC Pro-Am is a game that I like it, but at the same time, it's definitely got some rough spots.
Yeah, it's definitely got an AI that's fucking, like, a dick.
And I remember that as a kid, I had the worst time handling any sort of turns when you were not facing up and to the left.
Yeah. But I'd say that sums up a lot of Rare's, like, NES games. Their NES games just, like, fucking liked being a dick, I feel like. Point in case, let's look at Battletoads. Is there any game that likes being a dick more than Battletoads?
Probably. I'm just drawing a blank right now.
A game from Rare that likes being a dick more than Battletoads.
Ooh.
You know this fucking, like, hey, here's a gameplay style that we're just introducing you to this one level. Learn it now, and you have limited continues and lives. Have fun with that. Dragon Buster.
I mean, honestly, it's just a real dick, because you pretty much just start out, you're beating some folks up, and you're dropping down, and then suddenly, hey, you're on a sky cycle. Have fun not beating this level for approximately 10 years.
And if you do beat it, have fun playing levels that are even more difficult. Or yeah, a level that is actually glitched and impossible to play with two players, which is the...
The one with the wheels.
Yeah, I call it the pizza cutter level, because it literally looks like you're riding pizza cutters. The old school pizza cutters.
Yeah. I will be honest, though. Despite all that stuff, I actually like Battletoads. I think it's a really cool... I think like the variety of gameplay is really cool, and graphically and sound-wise, it's just really impressive for the NES.
I think we've had this talk. I hate Battletoads, but like I agree with your reasons for liking it, though, is the thing. I think it's one of those cases where if they just gave you unlimited continues, it would be far more tolerable. Because it at least would give you time to learn those levels.
Yeah, but then again, if they did that, then you'd beat the game in a day.
And? If the game's fun, you're going to play it regardless of if you beat it. Point in case, I can beat Super Mario Bros. 2 and Mega Man 2 without even thinking, and I still play those games a million times over.
Yeah, I guess. I mean, I guess it depends on how your household was. In my household, a family where they weren't too keen on video games, it was kind of like, no, you can't buy another game until you beat the ones you already have. So for me, beating a game was like, okay, cool, new game.
I guess. I don't know. Let's see. Anyways, Dragon Buster from Namco. Look at that sword swing.
That looks more like a... That's more like a dinosaur that just happens to spit fire.
I'm more amused by his, like, very circular sword swing. And look at that run cycle. How is that arm even like that?
What's in? Look at that skeleton. That sword. Oh, my God. He's having the time of his life.
Vitality. Oh, Namco, I love you. I think if I had to name three favorite companies, it'd be like it'd be Nintendo, Namco, and like Taito. But sadly, Taito and Namco has more to do with like their old school stuff and less to do with their modern stuff, and that's like kind of upsetting.
Oh, well, I guess that's just how it pees sometimes.
Yeah.
Like the people that come and go can really like, just change how the company is.
Yeah. Like, Nintendo still makes stuff I like, but they make some decisions that really makes me slap my forehead.
Yeah, that's definitely true.
But they still make better decisions than, say, Sega or, like, Capcom or...
Ubisoft or EA.
Or Konami.
Or Konami, yeah.
So it's like, they're like the better, but they still disappoint me, and that makes me sad.
Yeah, it's basically you come and say, like, I'm not mad, I'm just disappointed.
It's like, Ubisoft, when are you going to make another Rayman game? I've never actually played a Rayman game, but for some weird reason I still feel upset that you have not made a Rayman game.
I mean, the Rayman's creator recently left Ubisoft, so...
I think he left it out of frustration, but...
No, I think he left it because there were a lot of accusations of him being just, like, a really bad boss.
Oh, well. Can I believe otherwise just for the sake of, like, I don't know, I just want to?
All right.
That dragon.
Well, that was a dragon.
He turned
it from a dragon into a seizure warning.
I feel bad because I actually like dragons. Why am I killing my kind?
Yeah, like same, but I mean, eh.
But I've never played a Rayman game, but I've seen how upset people are over not getting a new Rayman game. So it just makes me feel like weirdly upset by, like, what's the phrase? By God, I don't know. Can't think of the word right now.
I don't know. Well, if you ever do get there, just play Rayman game. I recommend Legends.
I've heard that one's good.
Yeah.
I feel upset through osmosis. Is that does that work?
Oh, like upset by proxy, maybe?
Yeah, that feels good. That works. Yeah, actually, proxy is perfect. Yeah, because it's like I see how upset people are like about like. about like Rayman not being in there, and I've seen how many games he's been in, so it's like I feel like he should be in there even though I've never experienced any of his games.
Well, the thing about Rayman is that Rayman's been in a handful of quite a few games, but as far as games where Rayman is the titular character, there's only like, I want to say, 5?
That's still more than some characters.
Yeah. But even then, like, the first three, the two most recent ones were essentially just kind of starting over with Rayman. Like, you had Rayman 1, you had Rayman 2, The Great Escape. I think there was a Rayman 3, but I can't remember.
Anything's and better than the Rayman cartoon that got made, so.
There was a Rayman cartoon?
Oh, yeah. It only got, like, 6 episodes because it was so bad.
Oh, Lord.
And Billy West was Rayman. I saw it, like, a couple episodes of it, and I was like, God, this is terrible.
Oh, my
Even
God.
Billy can't save this. And I like Billy West.
He can only do so much.
Yeah. I like one of my favorite things about the movie Scoob was, like, Muttley's voice was, like, 50%, like, archived recordings by Don Messick and 50%, like, Billy West. It's like when they couldn't get it, when they couldn't find a recording that fits like the scene, like him saying "Smaggish freaking robots." It was like Billy West, who does a really good Muttley imitation. I'll be honest.
Look, this dragon just kind of like put him up. Look at him. He's doing it.
He's like put him up. He's all snaggle pussing it. Oh, that's good. Oh God. Okay, one more game, and I think we're good.
All right.
See, but shit, I forgot what I was gonna say. Billy West is good though. Billy West is a good voice actor.
Yeah, sure.
I think Futurama did a good job of showing how talented he actually was.
Yeah,
because he's like half the cast in that show. But it's like before that, like a lot of the roles he did, I don't feel like pushed him as much as that show did.
I mean, yeah, like he was just doing work. He'd just, you know, he'd sign on, he'd do a small number of voices in a show, then he'd just go to the next job, you know?
It was like he was in Doug and he was in Ren and Stimpy, and I don't think those gave him as much, didn't show his range as much as like Futurama did.
Yeah, no, Futurama was I'd say definitely a show where he kind of really became a breakout actor. Like that's when people really started kicking notice, like, "Oh, Billy West."
Yeah. Which I find it hilarious that he refused to be in a Ren and Stimpy adult party, because when he saw the first script to that, he was like, I'm not going to be in this because I think it would hurt my career. Boy, howdy, was he right.
I mean, to be fair, there are no lies detected in that sense.
I've only seen one episode of that show, and it was so horrible that I was just like, Jesus Christ, what the fuck? Which was like the Ren Gets Help episode, so... And then knowing about John Chris Belushi, it's just like, oh.
Yeah.
And that's enough about that, so.
Yeah.
Nostradamus is the game. Korean Fate. Version. Fate! Oh, wait, we played this game!
Face!
No, okay. I'm not going to play this game because we've already played this game. That was the one where we were like, Face!
How could you forget about Face?
I for some weird reason, wasn't thinking of Nostradamus and thinking of, instead, what is the original vampire?
Nosferatu?
Yeah, that was what I was thinking instead. I have had a lot of alcohol. You saw the percentage of alcohol in that last thing I drank. Yeah, because now that you, as soon as you said Face, I instantly remembered it. Because I was just like, because I remember, like, that was the one where it was just Face. We played Pula La Rula. I'm not going to do that one again.
Dang.
Snow
Brothers 2!
All right, I'll end on this game.
I say Snow Brothers 2 with. Snow Brothers 2 with new what now?
New elves.
Oh.
It's the American version of the Japanese version, because it actually changes the, like, characters.
Please!
The characters you get in this game is different depending on the version.
With new elves, that sure is a subtitle.
Oh, this is the English version. Look at those characters.
Oh my God, what the fuck? Just freaking snorkel Kappa over here.
I might have to play the Japanese version just to show how different it is. I do like this game, though, because it's pretty much Bubble Bobble, but they gave it ability that I'm amazed wasn't put in a Bubble Bobble style game earlier, which is the ability to jump down from, like, platforms.
Well, I mean, I guess if you design it so that that's designed around not being able to jump down, it works.
But it's like you just press down and jump, and it's like, wow, that feels like it should have been in every game of this style, and I don't know why it wasn't.
Well, I've had Avenger, I guess I'd say, in part because it gives you one fewer method of escape, you get trapped, and that means another quarter out of you.
Yeah, but I mean, it's one of those cases that when you see it actually put in a game, you're just like, wow, why was that? You know, it's like, it makes you feel like it should have been there forever.
You got those little Japanese runny feet.
I love it. Look at me go.
Whee.
Oh, I love when they do that in Zupapa, which is probably one of my favorite not hit Bubble Bobble clones that isn't Bubble Bobble. And that was on, like, the Neo Geo. My favorite Bubble Bobble clone is, of course, the original Bubble Bobble, but if I'm to pick one that's not Bubble Bobble, then Zupapa on the Neo Geo is my favorite.
Pam, I just want to repeat what you just said. My favorite Bubble Bobble clone is Bubble Bobble.
I know.
I think we might have a misunderstanding of what the word clone means.
Well, it pretty much, if I'm not playing the original, my favorite is Zupapa. How's that work?
Okay, there we go.
Though I do like Snow Brothers quite a bit, so.
Yeah, no, Snow Brothers, I like the mechanic, the whole just put him in a snowball and roll him around. Oh no, gambling.
Oh no, it's the thing that makes us instantly quit any, like, other game.
Yeah.
I actually like this game quite a bit. The only problem is it's actually really short. The reason is, if I remember right, Toaplon went out of business while they were making this game, and it had to be finished by another company. And that company kind of just took what they had and just said, yeah, whatever, and finished it really quickly.
I think he's dead.
And it's one of those cases where it's like, it feels like if this game had more levels, it would be, like, amazing. Does that make sense?
Yeah, that makes sense. Oh no. Oh my god. That train looked like a freaking streaker. Oh, that was great.
Because they'll have, like, random levels where instead of, like, being the one screen levels like most of these games do, it, like, will, like, scroll upward and you have to, like, go through the level, and it's actually kind of neat.
Alright.
Let's see. But it's been a while since I played this. I did a full playthrough of this game, like, ages ago. Like, freaking, like, literally ages ago.
Literally ages.
Like, maybe more than a decade ago.
Dang.
Yeah. It was back when I was in early, like, Let's Play days.
Oh my goodness.
Where I actually played the games by myself and did not have a co-commentator.
And I'm serious.
And realize that was not the best method for me.
Okay. God, given the Let's Plays have been around for so long now that I think about it, I think I may have actually recorded footage as long ago as the better part of 10 years now. It's kind of weird to think about.
I've been on YouTube for a long time, and the fact that I've just now gotten, like, 2,000, like, only recently got 2,000, like, viewers is kind of sad.
Well, you hit 2,000 subs?
Yeah.
Yo, nice. Congratulations.
Thank you. I didn't make a huge, like, I mentioned it on my Twitter once, but I didn't make a huge thing out of it either, so. I think I'll make, like, a video celebrating that when I make, like, 5,000 or something. I don't know.
5,000 is definitely a good number to celebrate.
I remember when I got 1,000, we watched, like, Popeye and Son.
Yeah, I can't not remember that.
Whoa. What the fuck?
Oh my god. That fish got you good.
That motherfucker just like shoot his nose at me. Is that pizza or is that Omonogiaki? Or... God, I can't even say that word.
I'm not sure. I'd have to see it again.
That food that I only know of because of Ranma.
Okonomiyaki, yeah.
Yes.
I've eaten it. It's pretty good.
It is pretty good. I remember I got it at like one Japanese restaurant and I liked it. Okay, that's totally spaghetti.
Spaghetti.
It's good, but it also is kind of weird because, like, it's got those, like, what is it? Crab flakes or fish flakes that, like, move whenever you, like, move because of the heat. It's kind of, like, weirdly unsettling when you first eat it.
I know takoyaki does that, but it's also been quite a while. Last time I had okonomiyaki, you might not have had everything on it you usually have on it. But yeah, no. The bonito flakes, they definitely, yeah.
It's a culture shock, for lack of better words.
Yeah, no, it's definitely a surprise.
I remember Ranma explained it as like, it's like Japanese pizza, and I was like, this is very much not pizza.
Honestly, that's probably the closest analog to it, though, because it's just kind of a casual food. It's small. It's flat. It's round. You put toppings on it. I mean, that's
it's an accurate imitation of what it is, but it's also at the same time does not give me the. It gives me an unexpected idea of what it's going to be at the same time. If that makes sense.
Yeah, definitely. No, yeah, no, that's absolutely correct. I would not disagree with you on that.
Let's see. And here we go, scrolling level.
These spiky bits on the bottom sure have me not nervous in the slightest.
This music is also not helping. I wish you could hear this music. This music is very, like, this is what my anxiety sounds like, music.
This is the soundtrack to my anxiety.
It is very, like, just, like, it just feels like it's just increasingly, like, making you feel nervous.
It's kind of funny how a lot of people are kind of like, oh, the thing of my anxiety is the drowning music in the song. But some people have, like, different ones. It's like...
No, this is, like, really fast and just feeling, like, kind of uncomfortable at the same time. It's like, it makes me feel like I have to finish something really fast or else I'm going to die. And it's not inaccurate considering this game.
Yeah, certainly not.
Damn it.
Uh-oh, the spikes are getting closer.
This game also doesn't have the best jumping physics, unfortunately.
It is actually surprising that you have a level like this, considering it's not really a platform game, strictly speaking. Like, well, not a platformer in the sense that the jumping is not the main mechanic.
Yeah. I stand by my statement that I had the original time I played this game for, like, Let's Play is, like, this is one of those games that I feel like if there wasn't the financial issues that Telefon was having at the time, this would have been, and they got more time to, like, work on this game, it could have been, like, one of the best games they made. But the situation they were put in, I don't feel like they got to make this game exactly how they wanted to, and that kind of causes, like, problems with the, like, gameplay, if that makes sense.
Yeah, yeah. Jump.
Oh no, they're taking her into a spaceship.
Put it in the mouth. Okay, bye.
It's like they're paying me off. It's like, we're taking your girlfriend now, here's some money.
She looks really unhappy.
Did I just kick a bomb clear into a spaceship?
Well, I guess she's dead now. Oh no.
I got questions and I don't want them answered.
That is way too much tongue for a first date.